Has anyone seen dirt?
For maybe an hour or so, or how long I have right now.
Dirt. Has anyone seen any dirt?
What kind of dirt? Oh, thanks for the lamp.
Any dirt?
I'm kidding.
It's literally everywhere.
It's like, all I see is the snowy dirt.
Overstorm, did you get clothes, man?
Not yet. Can do that more.
Alright, let me see.
Light level 18, that's amazing.
What is... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then... Look.
What?
That's what it says. For rawhide mantle.
No, the man.
Oh, never mind.
Let's do this.
Well, the 5 is small. The 3 is medium, and the 2 is large, and the 1 is huge. I would use the large instead of using all of the mediums.
Got it. Nope. This and this. Where's my house?
Here are a bunch of jabronis.
There's a mantle, trousers.
Go to my hut here, drop off this excess crock, just because I might need the additional storage.
Fur boots.
Actually, now that I'm thinking about it, if I... Whoa, hello. It's not my house. For the stream, this is Iggy's...
I don't know what the code is.
I couldn't type home. Iggy's HQ.
Speaking of Drifter, I'm having to practice. Yep, go in. Go in, go out. Go in, go out. And he's dead.
Alright, I'm streaming it, and we're going on a mining mission. I want this bismuth. Hopefully we don't fall in a hole. I hear that kazoo.
Yeah, it's like a kazoo, like drummers.
Where's...
It was me, I was starving.
No, it was like a while, it wasn't someone starving, it was literally like I heard like kazoos in like a drum beat.
I just heard a massive gong. Like a, yeah, not gong, but like a big grandfather clock tolling. He says, the winter bell? Question mark? But I don't know if that's what that is.
I've heard it before. It is winter, that's weird. Why would they tell us it's winter twice?
This amount of lamp is amazing, by the way. You have no idea.
You're welcome.
They eat it up.
Is that the one with a plate in it that makes it brighter?
It's apparently 4 levels lighter than the regular torch, so I'm not like running half in darkness anymore.
Caesar was saying that in addition to the lantern, you can put a plate in the lantern, which makes it even brighter.
Yeah.
Because it's like mirrored, basically. It's a direct light.
Internal reflection or whatever.
Alright, I'm going to try to science me something here. I'm going to try to make some visible icons on the map with stone stones.
I need a reminder of the waypoints that I made. It is used for bronze, eat it up, but the goal here is we have a trader that'll give us money to buy rare, hard-to-find seeds that come in these crack. They're called cracked vessels. You crack them open.
I hear jabronis.
And,
Where? On the side.
Right where I am.
We're gonna... Oh, goodness. Welcome. We're playing Vintage Story with a bunch of, Oh, my goodness. I didn't move the... Oh, no, I'm being attacked. Hang on. The host, I gotta deal with this guy. Oh, cool.
I'm gonna make it right around here. Yeah.
He's teaching me things.
He's invisible or not. It might just be hard to see in the dark, though.
Came here. Cool. We have a whole group that just got started. We're totally blind to, like, everything. I'm on the search for bismuth, and I show you the base, but I literally just left. Oh, my goodness. Not a fan of how many things spawn, but we're just kind of chilling and having a good time.
Yeah.
I'll be sure to follow you later.
Yeah.
Learn all the things.
We've got enough bony soil.
Pretty casual.
We're gonna find something.
And all of us just got into this game. It was Yogi the Monk got us all. This is a disaster. Okay, so there's a rift here. Okay. You know what we're not doing? Okay, we're done doing this. Yeah. Every time I fight things, that's generally how it goes. It's just not worth it. So how deep are you in this game?
Font?
Oh goodness, you know what you're doing.
Bitmap font.
The thing that really impresses, like, I'm not huge into the I play games like Factorio, Captain of Industry kind of stuff, so like the whole crafting situation and just like the little things you learn that you can do with stuff is incredibly interesting. Combat and that kind of stuff is oh my goodness, well, I'm gonna have to learn all the tricks from you. Setting up a base? I'm willing to start up those.
Probably can go to like Spreader's resource or something.
Yeah, the time sync is, yeah, I mean, like, I'm used to games where it's just automate everything, but we have a whole thing. Yogi will probably be streaming some of it later, I hope. He can show you around the whole base, because they all know how to craft the stuff. I'm on a mining mission to find the stuff that I've still not been able to find. I've been having a struggle. Yeah, there's a lot of grind. But it's just fun, though. Like I'm sure at some point I'll get bored of it, just because that's the way that I am, and just certain like UI things just being a bit rough around the edges. But, like, it was really fun to learn the game of digging for ores. I find that really fun. So that's clearly what I'm focusing on. So we're looking for stuff to make bismuth. And this is... I was looking to make a... This area is filled with cave-ins, and on top of that, we have this problem where... Oh, my goodness.
This is all it is.
I'm not being attacked, so... can we make
it's
it so
minus
we can
four,
see the
so it's like, what, 20-something? You would be uncomfortable. I mean, it's not that bad. Okay,
so we got a bunch of ladders, and the trick that I learned is basically...
I knew kids who went to school in winter in shorts and short sleeves to try to...
It's our group talking in the background.
Like, look at me, I'm edgy.
So like, the trick here is, really, you're just cold. So we're going to just basically dig straight down, and hopefully... see how good this is.
I mean, I literally do not own a winter jacket. I only own what most people would consider a spring jacket.
But yeah, pleasure that you found the stream. I'll definitely be checking you out. I couldn't imagine going without dying in this game. I'm not very good at like the combat, and I just found like berries and stuff at the beginning, and we just kind of continuously respawn and just get 50% of your satiety back. Okay, yeah. My strategy for staying warm in winter is to be in mines. That's the goal. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna dig down here a little bit and see if we can find the bismuth, which allegedly is here, and it's like the highest percentage I've found. So far, anything that's like high or ultra high is where I've actually found stuff. But the part I haven't found is I found the copper. I figured out copper, and that's easy enough. I can probably go find all the copper I ever need. But this one's tricky, and I've not really figured out.
Dialogue fonts.
Actually, I think I might have figured out a strategy here. Let's try this. So what we're gonna try is we're gonna try prospecting. So this area, I just have a thing that notes, just puts up waypoints for me. That remembers what I last did. So we're around 3.7%. So what we're gonna do is we dug one up there, and it used to do three things when you triangulate the spot. So it's gonna tell me. I feel that it gives me a little bit more certainty. It's sampling a lot of nearby blocks, but based on where we're doing it. Okay. So this is 3.7. So 3.7. We get my little notes out. 7. What we're going to look for here is to see if we're going to go down a little bit further, and we're going to see if prospecting again, the number's lower, because that might help me find, because I tried doing this a little bit with the Z direction, and it appeared that the Z direction, I thought it was just horizontally, and it was just like checking like all the blocks like in a large radius, but it seems that there's a little bit of precision.
Save myself time.
baked in. So what we're hoping to see is we go to do this. Well, the only thing that's changed here is the Z direction. So if this number is less, then we know where to dig. If it's not less, then we continue digging or go sideways. As far as progression, our group is roughly...
Well, something's throwing rocks at me.
Somewhere in Iron Age,
smack.
Yogi found a trader that got him, basically bumped us to kind of skip bronze a little bit, because the trader had a pick for iron stuff, and they found a massive iron mine. So that's the thing. See if the number changes. It is not. Maybe it doesn't change. We'll do one more, and then I'm going to start digging sideways, like in 10 increments. Take it easy, GHF. Is that what do you? What do I? What should I call you? Is GHF acceptable? Or whoa, we found something. Hello, quartz. Quartz. What? No one. Gotcha. Whoa! We found silver! How? Info log.
Gonna draw.
Okay. Well, I'm certainly not gonna... Don't tell me anything, but yeah, I think I read that somewhere. We're obviously gonna dig this. This is not what we expected to find, but for sure we're gonna dig it. I do know that this area, there's a bunch of native quartz deposits, so this is not exactly unexpected. But wow. A little bit of silver in here is probably useful for us, because I don't think anyone has found... If anyone's found any of this, they've not found much. I might be the only person kind of digging in these types of biomes, too, because I think they're all looking for iron, which I think is on the other side of the map. How are we doing on inventory space? Okay, I need to fix the inventory problem. Get out of here. Okay, well. I just pick up everything. It's crazy.
I didn't
stuff starts staying on the ground. I don't worry about it. Quartz is useful for stuff, right? Like, I'm not crazy. It makes glass, right? Pulverizes into glass. Okay. Hey, I found quartz and silver, which is not bismuth.
Silver is pretty valuable.
You turn the silver into plates, we can put it in our lanterns and they get brighter.
Ooh. Dump this, because I gotta figure out what's going on with my inventory here. I kind of don't need this copper anyway, so I got native chunks for this gravel. Picking up gravel. Just looking for stuff that hits the ground that I'm not picking up. And for the moment, we're good. Wow, bountiful? Whoa, what a hit. So I've basically been just dry for day. Like, I figured out copper, and then we've been on this search for literally anything else. Well, I'm looking for rarer things than iron. I figured iron would be when they found it, they just found a massive one. These other ones appear to be quite small. So what we need to do here is make a box at the top of this cave. Is there anything else? This is granite.
Here. Let's try to knock.
So we're gonna go back here.
One, two, three,
mark
four,
this with my
five,
little. I made a little
six,
macro.
Eight, nine. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Star is good? I don't know. I'll just call it 1, 2. But what we're going to do is we're going to put a box down just so I can have more inventory space and all that fun stuff.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Alright. I got to run.
Oh.
Wait, how freezing. Can there be
enemies here? This is literally just a... Well, I wish them luck. There's so many little caverns here that I'm surprised we don't just end up inside of one.
Oh, how'd you make glass?
No game. Of course I can't do that. I can't do shit. And alright. Box. Sure.
Is there anywhere warm?
Go in the smithy and you can make a fire there. Put a torch in the fuel thing that's lit.
Keep that in case I get in trouble. That should be enough space.
Vicky found some cheap clothes to make out of just leather pelts. They're called rawhide. Not leather pelts, just hides.
Oh dear. What am I adding to what?
Am I not allowed to put this on the ground? Please. I just want to put it on the ground.
Oh no.
Oh, it's because it's got snow on it.
Damn it. Oh, it's my torch.
It's interesting. You're only allowed the top layer.
Can you toss the torch out?
Okay.
Thanks.
Alright, let's go. It's amazing. I hit not even what I was looking. It's valuable,
freezing.
But I hit something I wasn't even looking for.
How do you smelt pork?
What the what?
How do you smelt pork?
Quart or quartz?
Quartz.
Okay. He's getting cut off, I think, by the voice skating is why.
God, I have this iron. I thought you were asking how to smelt quartz.
Liquid cake.
Way faster.
You mean glass?
Yeah. Oh, this is...
cool if we like somehow hit the bismuth as well. Sphalate.
Yeah, I wouldn't want to get molten glass out of the ground. That would suck. Well, let's see if this works.
This is an amazing large node. And I'm glad we're moving east. So the little star on my map, that's that was the cave in occurred.
Yeah,
I was literally on the surface just testing. And it turned into just everything in like a 10 to 15 square radius, sure. It caved in. Somehow I landed on a piece of sand or something, and I was stuck inside it with a bunch of drifters. I was able to throw down a ladder and somehow climb my way up and out of it, somehow without being like killed.
Explore.
I guess we're gonna fill up this trip on quartz.
Bowl of water.
Alright, so I am here. And this.
So are you able to use this anvil if the Helvehammer is hammering?
Use Iggy's.
There's one in my house. One?
There's a mold too if you need it.
Yeah, I know. I'm asking if he's tried using this one. Yes? No?
I have not.
Maybe.
No, I don't even know what it does. Is it just auto hammer your stuff?
Auto makes bars.
Just bars?
Out of iron blooms. Just heat up an iron balloon, put it on there, and come back later and get the bar before 10 minutes.
I was hoping it would automatically make, like, your stuff, your hammerheads.
It's not a...
This isn't Minecraft.
It's not an AI. It's just a...
I'm kind of surprised there aren't molds for some of the other stuff in the game. It's kind of weird to me.
That's what it would do in Minecraft, though. It would just, like, craft your gear automatically.
I'm thinking too much about Factorio. Yeah, granted, just, like, at some point,
focus on
automating everything because it's just experience. Not as fun once you've done it 100 times.
Does it normally take a really long time to light a bloomery?
Random.
There's so much here. Okay, we need to be careful here because we're getting near enemies.
Wait, oh, light a bloomery?
We're like 30. Yeah. 30 spaces away from
what do you
there's
mean?
A massive cavern.
Like with a torch?
When I say massive, I mean basically everything I tried to do on that particular...
So I'm assuming you've got the bloomeries, what, on a forge?
As you can see with the snow, like, everything is sort of divided into, like, these 32 by 32 blocks. 30 by 30 or something.
But you can light it with a torch, though.
You can. I had to try. I think it's slower.
Is it?
More silver.
Right. So I tried drawing.
Halloween time.
At least where
it's
I
all
was
one,
when I tried drawing
all the holidays at once.
Iconography on
our
the
wonderful
ground
Christmas,
with
the wonderful winter wonderland
slabs. I couldn't see them. I want to look at these roads now and see if these
more.
Are different.
You mean more? Okay, now we're getting close to it. You want all the quartz.
So this is...
What else are we here
No,
for?
It's the same or thing. It's stone path slab. It's the exact same thing.
I have
no.
blocks on me, so
you
if
don't
I
have
end up hitting the cavern,
here.
I can always
you
just block the cavern out.
Ooh.
More silver! Let's go.
You do have to.
No. Hopefully this doesn't continue to go in this direction, though. Alright, cool.
Where did all these dumps go? Break them all?
It appears to be that node.
What?
One here. What a hit. Like, really. Yeah, they don't show up
on
the crossbow.
You have to remake
thing.
This every time.
Break it?
Lit yet.
You break it.
More. Not gonna need any glass. More. Getting close to the enemies.
Yeah, that's interesting.
You need to shovel the snow, I'm guessing, in front of it. Because there's a hole.
There. This is very near the enemies.
Yep. You have to shovel
Being
the snow.
Here.
Can anyone think of anything permanent that we can put on the ground that is colored? Like a good, bright color.
You can buy stuff.
I'm definitely getting this color. That's why we're still digging.
Right there yet.
Well, I guess the thing is like the stone path slabs, we can see those, the ones Nabiki put way back. I put mine down though, I could not see them.
I'm almost full, to be honest.
So I'm not sure how long.
Raised ones?
Yes.
Okay, that's the end of this one. So
it's the exact same item. Maybe it just takes a long time for the minimap to update? That could have been something. Let me test that. Let me just put down a bunch of slabs and see if what happens, or I should say when it happens.
Okay, I'm not here.
It might just take a while to update.
You gotta be near the end of the node, because I mean, like, we know this ends in just an open room. It's just massive.
Well, that's instant. Weird.
Offense or defense.
Oh, you know what it might be? It might be because all the stuff around it is the same color that I couldn't see it. Lovely.
Just doing it. It could also be that we're nowhere actually anywhere near the cavern. Depth-wise, we might not be anywhere near it.
It's not even put down thing, it's put down thing away from other things. Gotta cheese the mini map.
Silver? It just continues forever.
This third one won't light.
More!
Yeah, now I have a dirt hole, which is the same color as what I put down, and that's the concern. It's not super easy to see.
Use a fire starter.
Hey, how you doing, Bob? We were looking for bismuth. We found silver in quartz.
Immediately.
Wow. Imagine an item called fire starter being able to start fire. Wow.
And it just continues forever. Okay, so we're now reaching the point.
Forge is a one. Oh, these bloomery bases rather are one.
Like, there's more here. I'm gonna go insane prior to, like... We can get out of here pretty easy. We're only 50 down.
Over here next to them.
Go make some clothes.
Stay in the mines.
Stuff up right now.
We're looking for bismuth because we can make bismuth items and sell them to a trader and make all the monies.
Plus 11 Celsius on my clothes. I never get cold anywhere.
I wonder if you get too hot in this game. Stuff everywhere.
What are you wearing?
Okay, we gotta get out of here.
Rawhide stuff.
Get our sanity back.
A fur coat.
Fur coat. What the hell?
Knee-high fur boots.
Alright, let's go back up. Hope we get the silver.
Yogis were... got.
Boots are just pelts.
A temporary mark here so that I remember that we were in this particular spot. We'd probably be pretty close to...
my hat or the poncho.
We have so much granite.
So even though we can create red dye, you can't just quote-unquote dye anything.
So much
clothes and stuff that. I can't just turn a block red, for example. I can make red glass.
Oh, shit. That's a problem.
But that's expensive to put down.
I have an idea. Let's go up. Let's go up this way.
Big. Ink in the oven.
At least restore our sanity just going straight up. Because I got cut off from the rest of the mine. This could go poorly. We might have a bunch of sand fall on us. But this is why I have a bunch of ladders. Hopefully, we don't just end up inside of a thing. It almost be at the point that, it's going to start turning into rift times.
I wonder if it's warmer in the earth, because it should be. It should be warmer as it goes down.
The rift activity level is.
Oh yes, wow. That's a huge difference. That's a 10 degrees C difference. Yeah, -12 at the surface, -2 down here.
Annoying. Other direction. We prevent a cave in here. We can hang out here for a little bit. Mark where this is. Extremely dual universe. I don't know. These games have a very limited interest to me. Question is, I don't know. I mean, we're in Granite Rock now, so this could be potential for a cave-in, which would really hurt us, I think. It would knock us all the way. Oh, good. No. Player run economy sounds like hell. Let's
open up one more here. Is the pit killing just these pits out here?
Yes.
Get away with that one.
Start filling it with grass. When it's full, you can then start filling the sticks. When that's done, you can cover it with firewood.
Put your item first.
What I'm going to try to do here is just push this all the way over so that if there's any cave in, it doesn't happen on top of me. Was my pick breaking?
How many do you put in at a time?
Bunch until you can't.
But touches like the dirt?
Let's try to.
Until you can't put any more in.
You'll be able to put one or four items in.
Zinc! Oh no! Oh no, we did it.
Big five grass.
Zinc.
For firing the fire bricks?
What is happening
bricks
today?
I haven't done. It could be more than four.
It's at 100.
Most items are one or four.
What is that? You have way too many in there, dude.
That's what I wouldn't just have.
Holy! It has to be down in the hole, dude.
That's what I thought, and I was like, hey, it's just letting
you have. You so have like sick. Two complete blocks of those.
Well,
things,
now I'm speedy.
I asked, and you were like, just do it until you can anymore. I was like, are you sure?
Yeah, when you're, all the way up. You're like, when you're filling the grass and the wood and the firewood, yes.
So how many do you put in?
The bricks?
Wow, zinc hard, actually hard to see. They need to change the sprite. Just it's very hard
hold
to see.
Grass with you and see when you can put grass in.
Okay. I've never
can
done this.
Can you spot
before,
the difference?
So no
there's
idea.
Like little black pieces in the sprite. Yeah, I found zinc while being attacked.
Excellent.
Okay, I found something interesting. I don't know how to use it, but this is interesting. Hit Control M.
Yeah, I made a macro.
That might be really useful. That might be really useful for making like as you're running, like just slamming down waypoints.
That's what I do.
What are your command for that, Iggy?
It's /, type / waypoint in the chat.
Okay.
And it'll show you what it is. My macro is literally the text that does that, and I signed it to a letter.
Okay.
Start with like one layer.
I don't know. It'll mine is set up. It just gives me a waypoint where I'm at. So that includes the Z coordinates, so it's awesome. But I have to edit it because it just puts a black dot. I don't know how to do anything else. No, eat it up, but you can.
It can do 12 at a time.
But you can do. There how do you go. Say?
I burned my bread here. Have some bird bread.
You can. There are like blasting bombs and stuff. Like there is a way to. I think you destroy everything though. So I don't know. I don't know what that would do for you besides like trying to find stuff a little bit faster. But no, generally, like if you want the ore, as far as I know, it's a pick. But like at the beginning of the game, you can grab sticks by hand. And you get shears later, and the shears just cut all the branches off the trees, and just stuff flies everywhere. You just get all the branches you'd ever need. Okay, this is amazing. I can't believe I found the zinc. I was looking for, like, basically... There you go. I didn't want to know, but there you go, there's your answer.
My guess is there might... Okay.
In theory, I'm going to be heavily disappointed.
I bet there's a way to do the icons. I wonder if there's also a way to do the colors, because
these granite rocks need
since
to be
everything in this game
the,
supposedly is
no, stop collecting them,
it's like
please.
A mod all the way down, it just may not be like documented well with the command.
Any use for this stone, and I'll just end up making more of it anyways. I just don't want to lose any of this actual bounty. So what did we learn here? Zinc was at 102. That's curious to me. It's very shallow. I had a hunch because of the type of rock. I mean, it certainly could spawn there according to the listed stuff. I've not found one. Now that I've found one, it has me curious on how to find more. Here, we're done in this section. Is there anything else in this section? No. Okay. Really wants me to have all the granite rock. Okay. Throwing them away. And ruining it for somebody, I'm sure. More zinc. Yeah, they need to fix this sprite. This is really, really hard. I don't know if color blindness is messing with me too, but.
Oh, dang, that sucks.
But,
I want the bread more closely.
If there's a mod or something that just makes it have like blue speckles or something. Because essentially what I'm doing is I'm just, to make sure I got it all,
Yogi's gonna get Baker's lung.
We're hitting all of them, and then basically making a cursory look to see, are they all granite now? If they're all granite, I guess I'm done. There's more zinc right here. Because one thing I've not seen is anytime ore spawns, they all seem to spawn in a clump. Like, you're not really gonna see... Like, it's going to snake around, sure, but it's not going to be set up in a way that, like, yeah. How are we doing on inventory space? Okay, we'll get more zinc.
Journal inventory.
I can actually go back and try to grab more quartz, too. Again, there's somebody actually here. I think. Can they hear them? Is it like? Is it tanked? Okay. Well, part of the issue here is just making sure I found all of it. And then see no more. Very hard to see. I think that needs to be changed.
Oh.
There's a mod that just changes the way that
it works
immediately. Happy.
Cocky.
Oh. Is that the surface? That I don't know. It looks like the surface. Try it. Let's go this way. Get out of here. did it. Drop that. Yeah, we did it. LOL! Yeah, I got attacked several times. So the original mine, he was in there, you jerk. So this, we were actually right up against this, and that's why we kept hearing things.
I'm gonna take a nap for the rest of my break.
That's how close it was. Interesting. So it's all right along that. Alright, so we're gonna go, we're gonna run back, we're gonna dump off all of our stuff while it's daytime. And we're gonna come back looking for, I think the only other thing we need to find is the stupid bismuth. So fun story, you can't put a crock pot down on snow covered spot. Way off to the.
You mean flank spread into anything else? Like a sandwich.
Gotta watch out for all these. It's like I'm Lewis Sacker. I dug a bunch of holes. Don't run into any of my holes. I guess prospecting holes almost work as like traps for enemies. If I made them a little bit bigger and I just knew to avoid them or something, they were always on a certain parallel. I don't know.
If you burn it. If you char the bread, it lasts longer, but it gives you less hunger, belly, or whatever.
Can you make a toaster? Asking for a friend.
Toaster?
Yeah.
Make a clay oven.
There was a wharf here of some kind. For that hole. There's garbage there. Eat it up, didn't get to see the sky bridge. Maybe I'll show off the sky bridge I made. Nobody else is as dumb as me. Like, they're building all these beautiful houses. I have a little shack. Let's go around the town here really quick. We got the main area. Got all the, everything is labeled neatly. This used to be our food place. We have a new food place. The new food place is this massive cellar. This thing, this behemoth, Captain Goop's been working on this. I'm gonna climb the stairs, open the gate, open the door, and we gotta go down. You go down. In here, gotta go down again. All the way down here. We have. This is, I think, where the cooking happens. Firewood. Here's the kitchen, pantry. All of these things are fresh for like the next a million years or year. All kinds of food and a bazillion crock pots, and I need to eat this food. I have one serving left. Alright, cool.
Water to install backwards.
Eat up. Now that it's empty, we put it back on the shelf. Got four more servings of stew, so we're good. But that is our. That's what Captain Goose been working on. Chop Ant's smithery. Which I don't even know what all the stuff does anymore. There was an anvil, now there's something that hits the anvil. Not it. Close the little gate. Alright. Now bunch of bushes, there's some farming stuff going on. Yeah, all this stuff. This used to be the smithery. It also burned down, so now Ant has a new smithery.
Is it snowing finally?
Yo.
Snow here. This is the new. I don't know why that. We got this guy. It's got an anvil.
He's trying to.
Got all kinds of stuff here.
Light a
million ingots everywhere.
Like a furnace, but it wouldn't work because he didn't shovel the snow in front of it.
Forges everywhere. This is Ant's personal box. Can't get in there. All of our molds. Pit kilns everywhere. Random torch. Forget what's over here. Oh, is this the greenhouse? Oh, it's just a house. And then here's my hut. There's a bunch of pits for all the animals and stuff to fall into. And Iggy's, I couldn't type anything more. It's Iggy's home for gambling gnomes. That's what I do. And I have a bunch of rocks to hit with a hammer. I need to make more ladders. I need shears, so I gotta go to our thing and grab some shears. Okay. Bunch of stuff I don't need. Granite, let's go away now. And here we're gonna hit the hit with a hammer. Okay, so there's nothing else that happens here besides it just turns into the respectable thing. Actually gonna need to put down another box for ores, so we're gonna do that. Or just empty this box for ores. Yes. Well, that's about the level of organization I'm capable of, so. Whatever I do with quartz chunks, it is not this, so I'm not going to worry about that. I'll leave that up to whoever needs to use it. Got 80 pieces of silver, 99, 125. Okay, that's not a bad haul. We're gonna go back and probably mine out the rest of that quartz so we attempt to not get popped in the process.
You guys get clothes together.
How am I doing on ladders? Need shears. I put the shears back.
I
think we have like nothing left on. I'm gonna go check our thing. If there's one on the wall.
I keep burning it. Bad baker.
I think I had like copper shears at one point, and then they just blew up. Crack hammer, cleaver. I guess the other thing is if we just have a bazillion sticks, that might also be fine. Iron shears. Oh, I put them back. Wow, this is a new one. Let me check to see if this is even worth my time, because if there's an entire box of twigs, then it's not really worth my time. I might as well be used. Firewood? No. We'll run a little firewood. There are not a lot of sticks. Okay. Alright, stick run it is. Here's my iron folks. In case I get attacked. So I just need a handful of ladders, because if we go do things, I'm gonna pull my ladders. What we're looking for here is any kind of bush. I think it's a bush. This is what I was talking about. Heat it up. At the beginning of the game, you have to like hope that things drop sticks.
I thought you were just giving me all of the bread.
You just hit bushes. You hit the branches on trees, and a million of them fall down.
part of a balanced diet.
The only issue is it's a little bit hard to, honestly, I probably could just do something like this, right?
Yeah, you gotta watch it real close or it burns.
Something like this. Probably could just leave them on here and just come back when they grow. Sticks. I got 39 sticks. Probably a bunch more on the ground here. I wish the catchment radius sometimes a little bit bigger. Just because, like, when you cut down a tree or something, it kind of loses its mind. It's hard to find everything. Well, this one I could just jump right on top of. Let's go. Oh. Wolf probably can't get me there either. Yeah, I think I figured out the strategy. It's probably better to throw ladders on things and climb up the tree. Look at this. Oh, you gotta... Because of the gravity situation, we gotta make sure that we do... Oh, it's snow. I'm actually just gonna leave ladder on this tree. Alright. So every 7 sticks is I think 3 ladders. I'm not even sure I picked up everything I just did. But, we're gonna take one more shot at that bismuth, try to clean up that quartz, and we're probably gonna call it, at least for the stream of day. Streams fancy. As you can see at the beginning of the game, like getting like 60 sticks is a real task. Whereas this, if it was daylight, I'd be able to see all the twigs way better. One thing I don't know is like if there's a strategy, like if I was just building, like if I was playing single player, I'd plant a bunch of trees together, and would it, is there a strategy to you know, see, there's a whole bunch here. So every 7 wild lines. This. Every 7 is 3 ladders. So if I have like 200 would make about 70 ladders. You can see, like, some of these are dropping, like, 3 every time. probably gonna clean up this area right here and we're done. Still the most, one of the most scary enemies to me, besides like flickering things I can't kill. Haunted Mount, Oral Land. Okay, we're back. Where's my hut? Oh, I can put the shears back. I don't think some of this is supposed to make a new one. I go through a lot of ladders. I should probably just either have Ant make one or make one myself. And, whatever you do with iron to make iron things happen. Ant, I can never find your smithery anymore.
It's okay if you use the wiki, because there's a link to the wiki inside the help.
Where's Ant's thing here? And do the thing. So we got wild vines and stuff. I don't know what the tip do. Oh, I had more ladders the whole time. Oh, there are the iron shears. Here. There were still sticks in the main box. Alright, I'm just gonna make a lot of ladders, even though at the moment. A lot of seeds, right. Just a dingus and didn't realize that I did that. End up with so much garbage every time we go places. Alright. 80 ladders is plenty. We're done with hammer time, so we gotta find that bismuth. Finding the bismuth is an important step. And we can go back, as long as there's anything else to do here. I don't know why my mouse is messed up. Alright. Hey Caesar, how you doing? Caesar's in the game. We're gonna do one more, we're gonna check that quartz out again, and then we're gonna do one bismuth run. See if we can find the bismuth there. Interesting. So, we learned that that quartz was awfully... This fence doesn't work. It's about to be nighttime. That's not good. How am I doing on axes? For pickaxes. I'm good. I don't know, we're just gonna keep running, because when we're running, these stupid things can't spawn on top of us. I've got 25 fertile soil. Let me just grab more fertile soil. Guess what, I got more soil now. Problem solved. Have I checked this? Let me look at my list of, I haven't checked this. Hold up. This is easy to check. I don't know why this wasn't checked. Just for the general idea of how much stuff is here. Garbage. It's like always. Obviously it doesn't have to be Earth-like, but like... Is anyone doing animal stuff? Is a bunch of sows useful?
Yeah, you can make more pigs with them if you've got a boar with them.
There's like 5 pigs.
They're well-fed.
Is the marker I just put on the map. I typed in the approximate coordinates if you're interested. Gotta get back here. Know where I'm going. Why is it like, why can't everything be frozen? Like, why is it not cold enough? Doesn't seem. Oh yeah, all it does is just add waypoints. Waypoints, yeah. Doesn't do it. It doesn't do anything special. It's either that, or I'd be literally typing them out or writing them down, which is just kind of dumb. But what it doesn't, it does not. I'm still writing it down when I get near stuff. So like if I want to, be careful here. There's some holes that are really bad, like that one. We don't. Whatever we roll, like it's not a desert, but it sure. Like I got games where it just rains all the time, and this one don't rain at all. Yeah, I was actually looking for a mod that gets rid of the kind of epilepsy-inducing things that happen. Just to turn off, like, all of it. Because it's not an in-game option, and then that happened. Okay. But yeah, for instance, the only highlighting it's doing is just the same block blockiness that you see. So it's a little bit nicer than the adding. So we're gonna go back to this particular spot.
Back.
Yeah. If somebody found desert in ours. Somebody did. Is this where I went in? No. Oh, this I think was a check at some point. Okay, so we're gonna go back in here, which is right next. Rift activity is calm. That's good to know. Where's my hole? I've also had a few of them I was testing crash, so I'm like, well, I don't want to deal with that either. Okay, I'm getting cold, guys. Where's my pit? Is it here? Oh. Okay. Is it really here? This is where we fell. I get the map zoom in. Did something fall? Another quartz entrance. Wait. Quartz hit. Okay. I'm at the wrong place. Yeah, I think I did find that and it crashed. I don't know if it's a version thing or what. Need to warm up. Yeah, I actually don't want them, Caesar. I'm over all the enemies in the game, very much so. Most entertaining pieces of the game to me. There's a drifter here still. Maybe just a regular drifter? Do I have a ranged weapon? No. I just kill him? Do I care? Am I likely to die here? It's the only guy. Oh, he's a deep drifter. Hello. Okay, we're out of here. We didn't take too much damage. Cool. See, that was really fun. I had so much fun there. And now I'm just done. Cool. Yeah. If I was playing alone, I would literally turn off all the enemies. The rift stuff and just enjoy exploring, building stuff. It's just not a very well thought out mechanic. So we did find other stuff though, so we want to do that. Kind of lame that actually it literally spawned on top of me, and that was how that step happened. So what do we do? Do we just do we want to dig back into the this particular thing? That I'm just starving to death. This was part of this cave. But we were over here. I don't know, what does this do? Can this go down?
Let's be working.
Okay, please. Please. Just kill me. This is my mine, isn't it? This looks like a mine and not. Yeah, there's granite from here. We like lots of negative 17. I have armor. It didn't matter. Mattered so much. It's freezing to death here. This is kind of a problem. We'll just go down more. I could just go back to my other thing and just like get to the point where I'm not freezing anymore. That's a thought, to be honest. Yeah, let's just go back to my other thing. I don't care if there's a deep drifter in there. I can deal with him.
Go
get not cold. Well, like this mechanic is bugging me. So hey, how you doing? Oh my god, I'm just dead now. Cool. Ooh, I get to run back. How fun is that? Alright, it's I find this mechanic just annoying. Ooh, I'm still freezing to the torch of some kind. Well, I could just run there. I don't really need. No, I do need something. I don't care if it's a sconce or whatever, I just need a torch. That's, well, that's one way to do it. I have one in my house. Fog. Yep, you say that, like, it hasn't mattered yet, so. Oh. That would be smart. Yeah, also I would turn off, like, if I kept enemies on, like, we're not dropping items. This is just wasted time. Me. What do you make? I see, like, this issue. Why can't I just have a thing that tells me how to make it? Grass. I guess we're using cattails because I don't really care. One. This will make it to me. Cool. Got a torch. Well, I'll worry about the fire starter when I don't have an issue of losing all my stuff. Try and go to 81. 81 minus 580. This will be daytime soon enough. But like, so one of the mechanics I really disliked about, like, this isn't Dark Souls at all, but like runbacks aren't fun. They never were fun. When people thought that was fun, it was not. But like, bleh. And basically the only times I die are when enemies literally spawn on top of me, or like, and then I don't get it. I should have had my bow though. My take would be a little bit more. Oh my god. Well, so much for that. As long as we don't fall in a hole. I didn't even, like, touch the... whatever. I can see enough. But I think we can get there. I want to keep going. I can see my holes in the desert. Key thing here is we do not fall in any of the massive pits that stupid room has made. Because, like, honestly, I considered just, like, going eastward and just finding a place that doesn't have all these massive room pits. Because that's really been the issue, is just that there's just seems to be a large contingency of areas for them to spawn. Oh great. Love running on this, because I can't see Jack. Better here. I've got to be close. There's the lantern. Now we gotta be careful because there is a massive hole somewhere. Right there. Alright, where's stupid drifter? And they're just gone. Right, give me all my stuff back, please, game. Whatever. Okay. Good? Good. Okay! Well, I want this quartz back. Give me this stuff back, please. Okay. We have food in us.
Yes, we need food.
Okay, we aren't freezing to death anymore. No, the granite can go back in here. I'm never going to use it. We have so much granite at the base, I don't think we'll ever run out. Okay. Alright, I gotta do this. Don't mind. The food. Alright. So, we're looking for bismuth. Do we already found a lot of quartz. We can always go back there. But what I'm looking for is the bismuth marking that I had. Oh, that is zinc. So we need to go where there was bismuth. Which is not here. We found it. We literally found it. Cool. Okay. So we gotta find bismuth.
It's a big tree.
I think at some point I did it over here. There it is. Okay. Alright. We're done here. Screw this area. We're done. Let's go. There's so many formations here. Alright, so we're gonna go try to find... No, game. No. I hate that so much sometimes. Alright. So what we're gonna do... We gotta go all the way out here. I mean, just knowing my luck, will be like an enemy in there, that stupid thing that summons 40 dudes. And then you kill anything, and then it just keeps summoning more, and like, okay, well, I guess the only opportunity here is, like, to just not kill anything and just pen everything. I'm like, okay, sounds great. When we stopped playing single player... Where am I? I wish when I opened up the map, it always... It always did it on top of me. Alright, so this ultra-high bismuth... Oh, the cascading gravel is great. I think it's great. It's just I don't want to deal with enemies. Dealing with cave-ins? Totally awesome. Oh, there's a whole forest here we've not exploited. Sticks? Okay, give me the sticks. Sticks. Well, sticks are free. Got granite stone here. So what I need to understand here, so I got bismuth or rather, is it called bismuthite? So bismuth ore, I need to know, occurs in... That's basalt, I don't care about that. Peridot. Highlights. This stuff might be really deep. It could also be in granite. Granite, andesite. Granite. Oh, really? Oh, we gotta get to our thing. Nope. Does not. Nope. Maybe it's just bug. So last we left our heroes, I think there was a rift here. Maybe it went away. But I starred that for some reason. Oh, nope, it was just rye. What was this? Bauxite. Okay. We need to get to our mine. Starve or get frozen to death. Don't jump in the water, it probably would kill us. I'm trying to understand, if it's so cold, why isn't the lake frozen? Ow. What is this, clay? Bauxite. Well, I have to die. What's my body temperature? 31. Try not to die to Jack Frost here. Isn't it like daytime? Why is it so cold? I guess it's only 9 o'clock in the morning. Alright. So I wrote down mine. I can only hope that there's a mine situation here. There is something. It looks like there isn't something. Oh, we're gonna start going down. More and more butts up. I figured it'd be like an option in the menu, like always when the mine does not work. Tried it, doesn't work for me. So we got a few layers here. Try to get deep enough to start warming up. What am I collecting? Oh, just granite again. We need these things in the proper order. It's always interesting when you die in this game that it doesn't remember. I mean, it doesn't. I get why it doesn't. Like, it doesn't remember your inventory. That was one of the reasons I distinctly turned it off in single player. Really annoying. Did not have the. I also don't understand, like, when I run out of a ladder, like, why. I played too much Factorio. I just expect hotbar items to always get replaced if I have 100 of them in my bags. Oh, that was a mistake. Are we deep enough to like not be freezing cold? We're still, it's only 6C higher. So we know this particular spot has a lot. What we're looking for is to see if we can find it. Current goal is to get this trader. Every time he refreshes, he wants bismuth stuff, and he'll give us seeds we don't have, and people are having trouble finding. So what I'm going for is to see. Whoa, we found it! I got the bismuth. Wow. That's a poor... though. We'll see where this takes us. Bismuth time. Am I at least not freezing cold anymore? I'm less not cold.
Mm-hmm.
Charismos. Wonder how much we're going to end up with. So this one was said to be, this was an ultra high concentration. So my guess is maybe there's just a whole bunch more. Pop a whole bunch of these. Still freezing? No, I'm warming up. So later, I guess I'm gonna have to learn how to do the, So this was found at a depth of 68. Okay, the spacer doesn't do anything. The great bismuth heist was a success. Got the bismuth. Hopefully there's a bunch on this side, otherwise I wouldn't say it's a bust, but like there's not a lot of ore here. There's... I don't know if the when I'm prospecting, if like whenever I find these and it's like poor, high quality, rich or whatever, it doesn't appear that the percentage like has anything to do with the quality of the underlying rock. I don't think it cares. This might be the end of the node. So I guess the question is, digging down for a minute here to see if we can find more. How much did we end up with? Oh goodness me. Please, game, please. I do not want to miss any actual ores because I'm picking up stuff I don't care about. Bring it, get out of here. Okay. I don't see anything more that we're done here. Oh! Found some. The other thing I noticed is, like, if it's a very flat surface, like the chunk of ore will basically be a similar shape to like if it's all jagged and stuff, that the ores are going to be all jagged, so you want to be a little bit more thorough what you're doing. Whereas when I hit the copper, like one of the I noticed, because one of the areas was very mountainous and the other was not. So the respective chunks of ore were kind of organized similarly to the way the surface looked. I just guessed because of the way how I think world generation works. I'm just going to be a little more thorough here since we missed some. I think it just goes on the ceiling. Not seeing anything more now. A wall of the granite, please. I don't need the granite. I don't see anything else here. So what we do when we finish a spot here, we still, okay, cool, that's fine. When we finish a spot, what we do is we plug the mine back. So it doesn't really matter how kind of big I'm making this. We're just gonna close off this section so that if anything spawns in here, it can't deal with us. It's us. Oh no, Caesar got bopped like that. See, just like that, we've now all. Okay. Let me go back down. Let's see if we can hit more bismuth.
And we'll call it a day. Put up signpost.
So we hit andesite.
I am. Also, Yogi, there's animals in this pit.
Oh dear. Okay.
We got chickens and this one next to the signpost. And then up here.
That was goats. Granite rock. So we know, well, we already knew him, but whoa. These weird markings.
Seem to be the best way to hunt is just take a bunch of pits and let them fall in and then kill them in there.
Not hunting, I'm gonna breed them.
Yeah.
I think it's the same process. You just get them in there.
You need like a fence or something.
Yeah, I was mostly worried about just trapping them at first.
So there really wasn't a lot of ore there, so I'm wondering, I'm just gonna go, I mean, this is how I do this. I just make a path all the way to the mantle. Oh dear.
If you feed them and it's the right season, they will breed. And then we can have infinigoats.
Until you run out of grain.
Basically check.
Until what?
Until you run out of food to feed them.
Well, they
we'll check to
grass.
See if we accomplish. Oh no, well, I broke my
ladder. They just eat grass?
Yeah.
Yep, oh, they just eat grass.
So I was gonna build a path to them, here. But.
Yeah.
They,
Have some meat snacks.
Yeah. Yeah, I was gonna build a path to them.
The mining is so much fun. It's like playing the Powerball.
Here to make me know what I feel like learning how to make iron stuff.
You only lose virtually.
Here are our rabbits. We don't feed the rabbits.
We lose so many copper picks. Hey. Finding nothing.
What do they eat? Snow. Nothing. They gotta eat something.
No, they just keep multiplying, and then I come in here and I'll take the meat and the pelt.
Wow. There's a chicken.
Yeah, there should be two chickens in here too.
Another one covered in snow.
The rabbits fall in here constantly, and they'll seem to multiply up to 7. And I didn't get a rooster in here, so the chickens can't multiply yet.
Plant like some berry bushes in the middle.
I don't know if you'll touching the more. Mantle gets you wrecked or not.
What am I doing?
Whoa, check this out. Look at this. Look at the snow. You can delete snow by placing dirt over top of it.
What?
That doesn't make any sense.
Windmill doesn't have enough power. Need more power. I don't have to slowly grind stuff though over time.
Yeah.
Okay, 5.7.
Better than standing there holding the button.
So we're gonna go
once
about
the,
20 blocks here.
Once the berry bushes start going again, I'm gonna start making a bunch
we're
of pies.
Dig this out.
I made 2 of the ovens.
Where do you put your ovens?
See if the percentage changes.
I never remember where things go. I have meat.
I should have done it down the middle. That's okay. I think move like a lot of squares.
Got 2 ovens here. You ever need to use them?
So you notice that the
dude, I suck at making bread,
down,
man. I keep forgetting.
So that tells me that there might be more.
More charred bread.
Between. So we'll keep that in mind to try.
Hope you guys like burnt toast.
But we also don't want to go insane, so let's go up a little bit.
Bread is great.
I'm gonna move these ovens and the rain and rot and bones, all the fertilizer stuff, to the big building next to the farm. Have a farm on both sides and animals next to it. It'll be next to the windmill that automatically grains the flour, or grinds the flour.
Bismuth. So we got this guy. One. Two.
Brad's really easy to make.
Again, please give me my food.
Just grind. Grind the grain into flour. Mix the flour with water. Make dough. And then... throw it in the heated oven.
Alright, so we'll take one more look at that, like, 15, around 15. Really dig that out.
What now? Waiting for winter to end.
Yeah.
Alright. I'm blacksmithing. What do you need?
Shovels.
Okay.
Also the location of walnut trees.
Walnuts specifically?
Yes.
Why?
For flooring. I have style digging.
I just didn't know there was a difference.
Hey, we're out of charcoal. I'm not smithing.
Oh no.
Can't smith out of charcoal.
I haven't touched it. Okay, so...
roll a set of logs, too.
15 and 60 at higher...
do we have any axes in there?
...than middle tier.
Nope.
Go back
need
up.
Charcoal.
Did we do 70? Yeah, we did. Okay, let's look
where
here.
Where nothing is being made.
Here is a walnut tree, but I'm aware of that. Oh my gosh, it's so hard to see people on the mini-map. I can see, like... the name 40 negative 70.
There's a copper axe.
I've got an iron axe now.
Whoa, who's found?
Animals! Look what I found!
Crafty Condi.
Walnut.
The follow.
So now I can look on the minimap. See what is this?
I didn't realize like people like want to see this game. This is like what is this emo? Is it yarn? Oh yeah, what do you, I'm assuming you do the
started.
Remake.
We have some logs in there.
Okay, so 80's no good. 80's no good. 80's no good. Go deeper? Question mark. Making this little notepad to see what I want to do with this mine. We'll check one more time at 90 here. My guess is that bismuth wouldn't be this high. The sea level's like... wow, so you won the originals. We got a whole group. I mean, be sure to follow Yogi the Monk. Because Yogi... our whole little retro community is playing it. So... oh, I did this wrong. I'm getting a reading. I get no reading because people are typing.
Deforestation.
I'll go back there.
Just use this one. Yeah, and it's fun. There's certain parts of the UI and stuff are rough around the edges, but it being like a small developer thing, okay, this is high.
I really like the snow effect, like when it falls
90.
And you just are momentarily 90 blinded.
90 apparently is super good. Okay.
It sounds like I'm being facetious, but I'm not actually really.
Well. BeefQL. What's Beef? Is that a friend of yours?
Oak.
BeefQL. No, everyone's completely green. I got like not UI, at least something that doesn't really change the. I wanted to get rid of the epilepsy inducing things in
my
the game
Alex learned the
and
phrase
screen
rock
shaking,
and roll.
Which that
whenever
one likes to crash, so we don't use it.
And
I just have a mod
goes,
that
yeah.
Just for like I wrote
really
I wrote some macros
excited.
for making waypoints, and
first,
I
like,
have the one
times.
That does the prospecting. Just because it's not fun to
no,
sit here and just literally type what's on the. Oh, okay,
yeah,
cool.
Keep him busy with like.
Do you stream
know,
the game?
World of Warcraft or something. Here's a 10,000 hour game. Have fun.
He's 6, so he's not quite there yet. But,
oh dear. Cool. I gotta follow you
game.
And. No,
see
no,
in 5 years.
Not, no name. I can't remember their name. Assumedly were a lot of y'all came from the host. Yeah. Yeah, because I'm basically going to do the mine here, wrap this up.
Between the ages of 2 and 3. Wow. It took them a while. Set up a little NES downstairs. Beat Kirby. We just got a picture of him giving the thumbs up.
Unless the prospecting just doesn't care about the Z coordinate. Oh no. Whoops.
Training him to win big 20 number 40.
Holy wood. Sorry to my ladder. Right.
This tree gave an insane amount of logs.
I'm just curious. I mean, this is.
Your bees.
Yeah, nice meeting you all. Have a good one. See ya.
Oh, there's the tree I just chopped. Dang.
Basically, I killed the bees. I'm gonna keep looking for some bismuth here, and then that's gonna be the stream. Yeah, pleasure. We usually stream other games, but oh, I got to hear the noise. Is it time for the drifter time? Yeah, it is drifter time. And guess what? Time anymore.
Never actually seen the Bicky Land.
To the west.
I know down, it's to the west. I made the sign.
Down the road.
So why was the reading 6% here? Okay, let's go
more torque. Need an engineer to come look at my gears and tell me what's wrong.
Continue looking just exploratory here.
I tried to make the main axle I took to the windmill hooked up to the big gear first. Then everything started jamming.
Go up more.
Then on the big gear there's one input and three outputs. And so I put a little gear as the input.
Okay.
And then I've got it hooked up to the corn and the
so we're gonna go deeper.
Auto hammer. And then no third output. This doesn't have a little power. Maybe it just needs to be higher. More wind.
Okay. I don't know. It was 6%. It bothers me. Let's do this. Pick some more samples. We found bismuth. This was not. We did the great bismuth heist. We did it. But there's gotta be more here. Okay. So 96 it went down. So if it went down by going down 6, okay, so what this tells me is we need to look right here. All this out. This was bismuth. This was all bismuth. Pretty sure. I don't want to get ambushed here. Oh, the torch that I put in stone. Is this the hit? Bismuth hit. That's somehow not. I guess the question would be, so if I do it right here and I get a reading that's still like super high, then it was this node. I'm triangulating it so my western direction. Oh, I'm gonna do this again. Triangulating it so here it only says 5.8. 6.1. 6.187. So if it's 6% at 90, it was 6.1 at 87, and it went down at 96. So here's the question. If we go down 5 more, what is the reading here? Because if the reading goes down, well, actually it's going to be the same, isn't it? I don't know where I need 2 more samples game. Goes down. So we have 5.9, 0.9 and 80. So we're below it. Okay. Is there any holes I need to plug here so we don't get ambushed? So my assumption is that there isn't anything. There's nothing else here. You know what actually might be an interesting idea? Is to, how do you say it? When we box off all this stuff, to just build larger things that we box off. Because if I did that, then when the stuff spawns around me, they're spawned just everywhere, not in where I'm mining. That's a thought. It's a very interesting thought. Just replenishing my stock of, this way, regain my sanity. Oregon. Liz, please let me put crackpot down. Thank you. Double please. Give me all the shovel things. Gave me a little tunnel. And I'm out of spaces. That's cool. Okay. As I grab a few more. I don't want to take up too much inventory space with it, but. So the next idea here, when we come back, is going to be to basically do another mine. But this time, have it be chest down here. There's a lot of stuff I don't need. Everyone always gets mad when I get the stuff at a different angle because I can't do it right. I think it has something to do with the way, like, the direction that I do it. All right. All right, well, let's go back down. 12 quarters. So we're gonna go all the way down here. So I said we were gonna dig around 15, see what happens. Because our readings went up in that spot. So right about here. I suppose it doesn't really matter if I start digging out like everything, right?
Then you can put coal in here.
This is actually a way more efficient way, I think, to do this. Because I have all the soil I want. This is an idea. The other thing that this is going to create is a... Let's just go up a couple. Trying. Got nothing. This is another nice reason to be doing the ladders, skipping every other ladder besides saving ladders. But it almost seems like we will need another. Have to build another mine and just go down and basically do the same process here. Got nothing. Do the whole thing, probably just the corners. 20 or 25. Might be the last pickaxe I have, to be honest. How many hits of this do I have left? 90. Let's use the prospecting one. Just so I don't have to run back. I have no other pickaxe on me. Oh no, I do, we're good. I guess the question I have to ask myself is, does that feel, that 6% being central there, does that feel like I had enough of what it is? How much bismuth did I end up with? 40 nodes out of however many it's measuring out of. Is that 6%?
Doesn't the
thing measure out of 1,000 or something? So I found 40, then I missed 20.
Thank you.
Well, I guess it could have been rich.
You're all... Oh, yeah. Okay.
I don't know, I got nothing here though.
Wow, you've got a house that isn't made of dirt.
I'm sorry, what?
We've got a house that's not made out of dirt and windows.
Yeah.
and skulls.
Doesn't appear to be anything here. Yeah, it almost seems like the next strategy here should be to just try to build a different mine room. You know? That was my one of my last pickaxe that I have with me. Yeah, I don't see anything here. It's all andesite. Okay. Plug it up. Done in this hole, we're gonna have to find a new hole. The area is good though. The thing I don't know is like how many, you know, if it says 6% and it says ultra high, how many hits should I be expecting in an area, right? That's the part I haven't figured out yet. Because the copper, like, I'm like, yeah, there was more copper than it was rich, and it was just a bazillion of them. These ones that are more subtle, it's like, well, if you find it, then you just say this whole, like, 3x3 grid is just done.
Hmm.
And that anything residual is just too rare to care about. But there's definitely, like, something, like, assuming the z-coordinate matters, there was definitely something that mattered. Like, when we were deeper here, the number did change. The number was higher down here. But I'm not seeing anything at all, so I'm about ready just to give up. Because usually, like, I ever try something to find more, usually I have to find. Okay. And so, like, here. This isn't gonna be very useful. It's just gonna say ultra high. Yeah, it's tricky. It's a fun little lottery. I don't like the other mode. We didn't have it enabled by default anyways. See, this number's a little bit lower than what we started on. I don't know, I'm not finding anything like these, but I think we're done here. No, we don't use that. I mean, I wouldn't say it's like it's in the game. I wouldn't say it's cheating, but like it really fundamentally alters how you're looking for ore, right? To me, it takes a lot of the fun out of it when I learned about the other mode. But certainly, you'll find a lot faster than we are. But yeah, all right, let's plug this up. All these fun drifters can just spawn here for us. All right. We didn't check this 48. I mean, 6%, I mean, it makes sense. Like, with a 34 one, I just found, like, 3 hits. And they were really good ones. They were rich, they were massive. So maybe that's just 6%. Yeah, there might be a random rock I missed in there. But if it's based out of every 1,000, and I found 40, it's pretty close to 6%. So if there's anything else, it might just be... I think when I come back to this region, I'm going to try prospecting in another thing and see if I find... You know, maybe I can try to find if there's more than one spot or not, you know? And just go from there. Alright. I give up. Maybe that's the strategy. Whenever I find a hit, I'm going to put a torch on it. If I had like those little lamp things, I guess that's a thing too. And I guess the question is, if I go eat, I really wish that stuff didn't spoil. I should have brought a shelf with me and just put a shelf up here. Yeah. Whatever, we're at the top. It's not like anything particularly dangerous is going to happen there. Yeah, it's like when I get back in the game, I'm going to be out of food. Fresh for 1.5 days. Can I make a shelf? Planks, they come from, I don't have a saw on me. I switched when I logged out, it didn't spoil everything. Is there anything else in this box that I need to take with me? And just so I can come back, I guess. I'm actually really far away from home here. Strategy time. I don't have a saw, so when I respawn, I'm not going to have any food. So I guess I do have to run back to the base and go grab more food next time I leave. What I should do is bring a shelf with me and put my food on a shelf so that I can log out. Well, what an interesting thing. I don't know if the shelf has to be indoors, but I can make it indoors. But we have enough bismuth to actually craft, so that'll work. Thanks for joining me and all that fun stuff. Thanks again for the host. Well, thank you personally once I have all my hands full with game. This game's way too addicting. But it's cool, there's a little community for Vintage Story. I honestly, because we just kind of wanted to play blind, so I didn't even think about, oh well, should check out people streaming it. But I think we're getting toward the point that we've seen a lot of what there is to see in the game, but not everything. Oh, that's cool. Yeah, I mean, the game's still great. I wish there were some, you know, some of the things I mentioned were a little bit more polished, but, like, there's a lot going on in this game. I'm certainly not, like, unhappy. I think I'd be a little more frustrated in a single-player situation, but, like, I think I said earlier, I don't know if you were here, but I'd just be like, well, I love that I can turn all the stuff off. That's perfect. If I want to just play explore mode with no enemies and no, you know, yeah. But I mean, like, early access is sort of this, how do you say? I mean, like, it's certainly more finished than a lot of other things, but it's just like, hasn't the game been in development for 6 years or something? I don't know. It's been around a while. Oh, we need to get away from these guys. I don't want to deal with these guys. There's like a rift. There was a rift there, and it was a rune, and that was our first hit with zinc earlier. But I mean, you know, that's always a, yeah, I mean, it's one of those agile, it's always in development type situations. Where's my, if I kill this guy? So bad at killing things in this game. Next thing I know, he's gonna run me into a pit. So if we're done here, I can't wait. Yeah. There's a lot, like to me, I wish there was a way to turn off, like once you've done the smithing, and, like, I just want, like, 10 of them. I don't want to do it 10 times. Let's see how this trader's doing, since I've not seen him in a little bit. So we have this trader. This is the whole reason we went for the bismuth, is there's a trader here that he wants all this bismuth stuff, tin and bismuth, and wants another longbow. But, and he was, well, he's not giving them anymore. Otello, that's hilarious. Hey Yogi, I can buy Otello.
A what?
Reversey.
What?
Don't you want the Omak tabletop? There's a black guard helm here. Trader still wants. He doesn't. He doesn't have the seeds right now. The treasure hunter guy, but he is looking for longbows. Brian. He always seems to be looking for like bismuth stuff. I don't know why that is, but yeah. Also a leather backpack, but he can't have the leather.
Yeah, and the cheapest ones are charcoal. And sometimes they'll want copper ingots.
Yeah, we made bank on that yesterday.
Charcoal and something else. Ceramic bowls. This one guy wanted like 24 ceramic bowls.
24? I've never seen somebody want that many.
Why? That's why we have so many, because I made them and then I went back to him and he didn't want it anymore.
Yeah, it seems like they kind of go through, like, I don't know if it's like a tier or something, but like this, that treasure hunter, it's a lot of easy gears since he wants like 5 to 7, he'll give you 5 to 7 gears for each of them and he restocks. Like, just whenever we find a trader with money, we just with the stuff we want, we'll be set. That's my goal for later. I found bismuth. I got the zinc. I gotta learn how to do the alloy. I think I figured out a little bit more how mining works as well. Like, I feel pretty confident. Oh, it's rye. Really, I didn't get it? Oh, is it because I knifed it? Could have used my hand, I guess. I think that the bunch that I found, like, that was the only node in that area. Cause I looked. They changed your stock. Yeah, I saw. Yep. But I don't want to know like any kind of spoilery. Like, it's kind of hard because I know some of the help files and stuff are a little bit leave a little bit to be desired or inconsistent. But yeah, we're aware that there's a little thing, and there's only so much money they have. Some other games that we play have features like that. But what we don't know is, like, are they
11 iron chains? Oh dear.
Are they always asking for the same items? Basically, I am way far away from where I need to be. This is a very interesting. We haven't prospected any of this. All right. Seeds, yes. So I've been marking how the generation happens for farming stuff. Trying to find like if it generates like in a band, goes in a particular direction. Is there any more here? I'm curious, since we're here. Oh, nobody got whiffed.
Yogi, when you're back at the base, I have something neat to show you.
I'm here.
Look at my lantern.
Zero traces of ore. Okay, well, enjoy that.
What am I looking at?
Zero chases. Green. Traces.
Get a green lantern.
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool.
You can put down colored glass and it changes the color of your light source.
Ooh.
Oh dear.
See, I love little details like that. Like, that's kind of stuff that gets me excited with this game.
Oh, there's a rift right next to our base.
I can't believe that there's literal. How is it just zero ores? A little tunnel.
Green. Silver plate.
Wait, we have silver plates?
Gold plate. Losing. It only makes it go up by 2.
I will take any additional light.
It was from 18 to 20, which is like... an 11% increase, I guess. I don't know.
Most people would kill for an 11% increase in anything.
What do I have marked here? Some kind of bees or something?
Also, silver used for anything.
I think it was rye.
Boiler. Condenser. We gotta booze it up. There's no entertainment in this world.
What about Othello? Go buy you
Othello. All I do is create gears every day.
Where's this rift?
Chains, I guess.
You didn't get a chance to see. I'll run through our base really quick. Apparently we have a windmill now. I didn't realize that. I guess that's what the gears were for. But we got, this was our, all of our, the heck are these? Vertical rack. That's cool. But those. Yogi's here. He's doing things. This is our smithery. Bars everywhere. I'm gonna steal one of these for money later. Naturally, I don't have. Oh, I don't have the orb in. Oh well.
The question. Has this game changed how you look at things in the world?
A forge?
So I'm getting some weird Tetris effect stuff.
I had one today. I saw a bunch of somebody did tree trimming, and there was tree trimming. So somebody had a branch with a bunch of leaves on it under their tree, and I was like, oh man, I could turn that into sticks as I was driving by it.
Yeah. Oh dear.
Yeah, I know, it's bad. We're just trying to,
like, I seriously like noticed this, trees, and I was like looking for the differences. I was just like looking at how things were constructed, and being like, oh well, you actually would need a road going here. Like, this doesn't make any sense.
That was a truffle bit.
There was someone in the middle of the aisle of the grocery store, and I thought, man, I wish I could throw them into a pit trap.
Yep, so we got our forge. That was Ant Smithery. I don't know what this house does, but this, I think, is somebody's ornate house.
Okay, here we go.
I'll show you one other thing.
Gear thing.
Well, apparently we have that gear thing now, too. There's goofs.
Yeah, let's do
it.
We
have, this is making more charcoal.
Out of hammering and making grain.
But this is, where'd you chat in a second?
But it's kind of slow.
So this is Captain Goof's,
like, we're sure. Doesn't have to.
This is our food stores, apparently. Oh, I'm out of food.
I need a, well, it does, because if it doesn't finish the bar by the time the bar cools off, then it's not going to finish it.
I'm in the right place.
That probably means you don't have hot enough stuff.
No, I mean, we don't have enough power in from the window. How do I make it have more power over Swarm? Come here and look at it.
Is that empty now? Okay, so if this fire crack's empty, so I actually get to return it. Yep, so Captain Goop made this, which is our food stores.
I'm not really.
Yeah, I don't know why it doesn't. I don't know why it goes like this, but it does. All the way down.
Other than.
And there's all our.
Making the windmill higher or adding.
Forever,
it's still only 4 out of 5.
We didn't know what was going to happen for winter, so.
Sales.
Grab a pot.
Is that add some, making it higher,
Like I might as well I'll scrap one.
May or may not add some because the higher it goes, like
everything's cooking.
The more energy is lost because it's taller.
And we'll stop at my
but
house,
then you gain more because it's windier.
Nowhere near as impressive as any of this because I'm too much of a power player.
Sounds like you need a battery system.
I'm amazed they all spent a lot of time on this,
and
it's really cool.
Have gravity transport the energy down.
But I'm like, I want it to mine. Give me, let me pour things in crucibles so I can mine.
More advanced machinery.
I wish I had more buttons for you to. Because I got, of course, it's like the screen is very large. So I can only see part of chat. So I see your comment.
Speed up rotation or slow down rotation with stronger torque.
All right. Well, bazillion bushes. We have a whole farming thing going too.
Speed up rotation.
I'm not sure it's functional because it's. I don't think anyone built a greenhouse. This massive house, and then you see all of this stuff. And we got a bunch of pits for animals and grifters. This is Iggy's, supposed to say home, but I can't go that far. Iggy's home for gambling gnomes because we're looking for all the ores. And because there's no lights in it, grifters spawn all the time. That's it. I guess I got snow and grass coming through the roof. This is my terrible home. There you go. That's the what would you say? I mean, I used to think about this. Oh no. Someone in chat agreed to the Yogi. That's how they think about people anyways. Before they got this game. Alright. So, thanks again for the host. Thanks again for the host, No One. It was No One, I was right. Good to see Bob for... Bob Farr, I want to say it in German, and I don't know if that's correct, ever. Good to see Eat It Up. We saw Poppersnot. Thanks for the follow. Zyshia and Crafty Candy. Have a good night, everybody. Hey, Yogi, are you going to stream Vintage Story?
Maybe.
Okay.
I'm gonna eat first.
Yeah, that's what I'm stopping to eat. There's a group, this person known as No One hosted me. And I guess they're doing survival and they've lasted like 180 days without dying. Like I mentioned immediately that Yogi is the we're kind of the kings, especially the Yogi, of just dying to refresh your food clock.
I'm the exact opposite of that person. I maximize
excuse me, it's permadeath as well. They're literally playing, I mean, yeah. It wasn't just, not dying, they're playing permadeath style.
That sounds awesome.
Like,
I wouldn't want to do that the first time I was playing it.
Yeah, but with what we know now, it would be a lot easier. I mean, you just build...
Okay, so this not being downstairs is not going to last as long. That's okay.
If I was going to
pits.
Do it...
Pits for fighting. You never fight anything, like in melee. You just lead them into a pit. Or you don't fight it.
Can I just make a...
If I was going to do it, I would either...
Can I make a cellar really quick?
It would either need to be some sort of, like, stream event.
Any enclosed space.
Or it would need to be, like, a competition with teams.
The most simple cellar consists of a 2x1.
So that way you wouldn't just like be super angry if like, somebody died. Like, oh, Yogi fell.
We got PvP, permadeath.
Yeah. Oh man. That would actually be pretty wild to watch. Like, one group is like focused entirely on survival. The other group is just like, we build arrows as quickly
now.
As possible. We find them. We kill them.
Now I'm legitimately curious. Go in there, I'll deal with you there.
I wonder if we could, like, kickstart, like, a survival or survivor show where it's just this game.
Curious if I can exploit this.
Big win.
Hunger Games inventory? Yeah, well.
Big.
Wow.
Fresh for 8.9 days.
What?
Hello.
Just wish I don't know. I have no idea, but it's on a shelf, so it's as best as it's gonna be. Alright, take it easy, my friends. Yogi the Monk might stream it a little bit later after they eat. Be sure to check them out. That's basically where I would host, because they're playing Vintage Story. Is anybody else playing Vintage Story? Can we go say hi to them? There are others. Oh, Crafty's streaming. Cool. Let's go say hi to Crafty. Take it easy, everybody.